Syndicate official dance marathon time, 11:14:30. I couldn't even work for the Weather Bureau. With me in the studio right now is Mr. Scott Randolph, who we have seen in quite a number of things this evening. In addition to live in person, having him as a disc jockey and seeing him dancing up a storm on the floor. A couple other things, none of the least of which has been a very interesting 1984 rock concert. Tell us a little bit about this idea and why you were so anxious to have it perform.
Well,
where did the idea come from?
It started out as Jerry McGrath, the other person in it, another male in it, that we wanted to do a rock concert together. And Jerry and I started working on this idea that we wanted to do Bryan Adams. And we felt that the best song was Take Me Back, because we thought of some really good ideas to do, you know, with the video. And eventually the ideas just grew, and I just started writing up a script. And eventually, it was something that I think had to be said. That as for his last year's rock concert, it was kind of a disappointment I felt personally. And I felt that I had to make a comeback.
You didn't like last year's?
No,
why?
I thought last year's was good. It had a lot of good qualities. But I think that the group that we did, Rush, is not as popular as Bryan Adams.
Mm-hmm. Keep talking.
So it was an interesting video, and it was a lot of fun to do.
Where did you get the ideas for the setup and the situation and so forth? Because it was, you know, it was a rather elaborate shoot.
Well, it all started when I just listened to the song at night, just had the headphones on, you know, laying there, you know, thinking about it, and as the song was playing, like, different images came into my mind. And then eventually I just was putting it into something that we can do in a 2-hour limit. And, you know, it's just from listening to the song over and over and over, and ideas just keep coming to you. And just one idea comes and then another one just kind of flows, and then we came up with that.
Does this type of creativity come to you when you do other projects, or was it just the fact that it was a rock concert or what have you? Have you ever gotten involved with scripting or laying something out? That was a very, very elaborate production.
I find it, I don't know, easy to do video. Those rock videos, for some reason, like, the ideas just come to me very naturally and quickly, and they just seem to build on top of each other. But as far as, coming up with other scripts, I have come up with some other ideas, you know, as far as like movies and things, but never had the time or the energy to do it yet. I plan to someday.
Okay, let's provide the specifics, though. In this situation, once you had committed yourself to the song, and once the script or the plot line was established, how much pre-production and how much production work was involved in terms of time in the actual shooting?
Well, we had to set up when we got there. And it was very easy because it was my friend's house that we were at, that we filmed it at. And the house has been sold, so the house was empty. You know, there's like, we were, you know, basically by ourselves in there. And it went very quickly because I knew what, you know, had to be shot, and, you know, where I wanted it to be shot and what was the quickest way to do it. It didn't take very long at all. We did have one complication, though.
Oh, what was that?
The girl who you saw in the video was not supposed to be in the video. We had another syndicate that was supposed to be in it, Jill Degenhart. Anybody know her? Anyway. She...
We all know Jill.
Jill was sick the day we were supposed to shoot, and she just couldn't make it out to our shoot, so we made a last minute call. So that was our only complication.
We've run into that problem here at CineKid with quite a number of actors and actresses, and this young lady did a very fine job. Has she ever done anything like this before?
She's done stage acting for the Happy Horsham High School for the plays. But outside of that, she's not done anything else. So it was a brand new experience for her. You know, she's never done anything before in any kind of camera, in front of another kind of camera.
Right.
Okay, thank you, Scott. What I'd like to ask you folks to do is to join us as we cut now, live, downstairs to the Roger L. Gordon Audion and watch the 1984 Dance Marathon as it continues live.
Right.
How about that? Okay, they're still alive and well, and we've got 35 minutes to go. We're still here. The phones are still working. We'd like to hear the bells ringing, and especially the sound of bells as the computer hits those high notes all the way up the scale. The boys and girls of Cinekid will benefit not only from dollars that go into production. I think there's a great misconception, especially among people who really don't know what Cinekid is that well. We work primarily with young people. We are considered to be very conservative in our approach. We will be expanding our services very shortly to include a rather ambitious program to offer youngsters who are having difficulties with their schoolwork in a tutoring service right here as part of our operation. In addition, we will be expanding quite a number of the services that we feel will enrich and enhance the lives of the young people who are members of the Cinekid organization. Our way of communicating with kids, of course, is through the field of communication. We attempt, moreover, to encourage and to teach them a sense of responsibility, that you are given a job and it's up to you to finish the job. We frequently find ourselves, interestingly enough, not always on the same wavelength as parents. Our philosophy is really quite old-fashioned. We would like our youngsters to emerge as very, very capable adults. And the only way that they're going to be able to do that is to be given the chance to take charge of part of their life, but having accepted responsibilities to learn to establish priorities and learn to finish a job and to do it the very best way that they can. That life is not just taking, it is giving as well. And that's part of what makes Cinekid tick. The other part is what you're going to look at now. A fantastic presentation, a sample of things from the youngest members of our organization. This is a 1984 rock concert, and the song is Uptown Girl, and these are our kids. Let's watch.
We'll be right back.
Okay, there's the uptown girl. And with me in the studio is somebody who is responsible for a great deal of what takes place on Saturday morning, like Miss Paula Coleman. April Richard is not only a member of the track program, but she is one of the teaching assistants who shares her talent and her time with our kids. We've spent some time with Paula. I'd like to share the same thoughts with you. Why would you have ever been interested in the first place in giving up your Saturday mornings to work so closely with our youngest Cine kids?
Well, I think that the younger members of the Cine kid program have potential to go into the track program. So they have a lot of experience. They're not graded as track or better than Tyro. They're just as good. And I like working with the kids.
Have you ever worked with youngsters previously?
Nope.
This for you was the first time in many respects.
Yes.
How have you found it? What for you is the best part of being on the teaching staff of the Tyro program?
The kids, they're great. I mean, they work with you good. They're the best bunch of kids I've ever seen. And the experience of working with other people.
Paula felt that young people who are part of Tyro bring something a little special when they get here, but that the environment also makes them a little different from the average group of kids from 7 to 11 years, that they are, I'm going to paraphrase her comments, a little more outgoing and a lot more willing to try new things because they consider this a very safe environment where they're encouraged to experiment and where other people won't point a finger and make fun of them. Do you feel that the students with whom you work are different, let's say, from boys and girls that you may have come in contact with in, you know, other occasions where you saw youngsters that age?
Most definitely. They're well behaved and they're just a really good bunch of kids.
Mm-hmm. The program has more than doubled in the past year. The extension, the camp program, was rated one of the top 6 day camp programs in the Delaware Valley by Philadelphia Magazine. What, in your opinion, is it that makes Tyro and Camp Cine Kid so special? Why are the kids special? What do they draw from that program?
Mr. Abbott really works very well with them, and he's probably the best teacher of the little kids I've ever seen. And the other staff members are very good with them.
Mm-hmm. People, of course, Mr. Robert Conrad, who is president of the Upper Moreland School Board, made a statement that he said, programs do not change people. People change people. In essence, what you're saying, of course, is that the highlight or the main part of the Tyro program would be the people, including yourself, who actually relate to the kids. What happens in that interaction that makes this experience so special to youngsters? How does Mr. Abbott, how does his staff work with these young kids that separates Tyro from other, you know, children's programs?
We work with them individually. We don't work with them as a group. It's not like, okay, you're a group and you're going to do this. We will tell them what their daily plans are, but then we'll work with each individual closely on each aspect and whatever they're interested in.
Thank you, April. Miss April Richard, who is part of the track program, she is also responsible for development of our Kidbits series. She's working on a new series called It's Eddie Hodges. She is a teacher in the Tyro program. She has edited quite a number of things that you see almost weekly and is an integral part, though, of sharing her knowledge with the kids who are just beginning their experience at Cine Kid. Let's return to the dance floor, as it were, and in just a minute or two, we'll have that graphic up again, because it's during this last half hour that I'd like you to discover that our telephones will be working right up through midnight. Let's watch the kids downstairs in the Roger L. Gordon Audion, and we'll put the graphic up so you can see where to call to make the last pledge of the day.
Okay, the winners there were Frank and Heather. They want to come up and get their envelopes. And next song is by the Police.
Should be coming up.
Twenty-one minutes before 12 o'clock at night, as we hang in there till the bitter end, the exciting conclusion to a very successful activity, the first of its kind, first in the world, a spectacular dance marathon and cable telethon produced entirely by our kids. Our thanks once more to the folks along the Comcast Cable Network, to our friends at the New Jersey Public Broadcast System, to the Upper Moreland School District, and to the staff, the parents, the board, and the children who are part of CineKid, who once again have really worked very hard to make it happen. I'd like to share with you one other video segment right now that is a happy way to sort of come down on the hour. Here's a clip from a show that went out at the very end of 1982, the beginning of 1983, actually. It was shot during 2 days. It was our salute to children's shows of the 1950s. We called it It's Dowdy Hootie Time. This is just a little taste, a couple minutes, of what had to be one of the goofiest, funniest programs that we've ever done. Let's watch.
Boys and girls.
Hi, Bison Bill.
And now it's time to bring out the president of Hootieville, none other than Dowdy Hootie.
Yay!
Gosh, Bison Bill, look at how many nice boys and girls we have today.
Yay!
Gosh, Bison Bill, what are we going to do today?
Well, boys and girls,
Bison Bill, excuse me, Bison Bill.
It's Mrs. Richfield, boys and girls. Her husband owns the television station.
Yay!
What are you doing in Hootieville, Mrs. Richfield?
Well, Mr. Richfield and I have discussed this at great lengths, and we have decided that since Mary Bell is growing up, that all the programs on Richfield Network should have more culture and refinement.
Gosh, Dilly, culture!
Gosh, Bison Bill, what's culture?
Well, Dowdy, culture is museums and opera and ballet. It's all the finer things in life.
That's right. Now remember, Mr. Richfield and I will be watching from the control room to see that this television program has more culture and refinement. Now come along, Mary Bell.
Gosh, boys and girls, culture!
Yay!
We've said it for years. Hootieville needs more culture. Isn't that right, Juan?
See?
Oh, boys and girls, it's Philo T. Blaster and his brother, Juan Valdez.
Boo!
What are you doing here?
My brother Juan here is my campaign manager. And I am going to become the next president of Hootieville.
Ida-di-da-di-da!
And unless I miss my guess, if you don't get more culture into this program, you'll have no program. And I will be the next president of Hootieville.
Scott, Mr. Bill, what are we gonna do?
Well, let's not worry about that now, Dowdy. It's time to meet the boys and girls in the Walnut Gallery.
Yay!
Our friends at Roscoe Chocolate have a present for each and every one of you. But first, we've got to find out your names.
Sally. Marty.
Gasly.
Manfred.
Quentin. Ben. That was pretty good, boys and girls, but I couldn't hear all of you because you were making so much noise. Let's try it again.
Sally. Marty.
Gasly.
What's the matter? Mr. Blaster isn't back, is he?
No!
Juan Valdez isn't back, is he?
No!
Mrs. Richfield isn't back, is she?
No!
Well, then what could... It's time to bring out our next guests, Cowboy Buck Mixer and Cowgirl Dale Mixer.
Yay!
Howdy, pards.
Howdy, cowboys.
I'm going to go see if I can get myself cleaned up, Dowdy. Why don't you explain to the boys and girls what they're going to show us today?
Gosh, boys and girls, we're going to learn how to rope a steer.
Yay!
Now, since Hootieville isn't big enough to bring a real steer into, Cowgirl Dale here is going to act like one, and I'm going to rope her.
Yay!
Wait a minute. When I agreed to do this dog and kid show, I didn't know I'd end up playing a steer. Here, you play the steer, and I'll rope you.
Yay!
Wait a minute. I'm a cowboy, and you are a cowboy. And you're gonna be the steer.
Yay!
Here, prove the puppet.
Not on your life.
Me neither.
Yay!
Maybe next time, pard. Let's hear it for Cowboy Buck Mixer Boy.
Yay!
Okay, we're going to go back there in just a minute or two, but I thought it would be interesting to share a final observation with a young person who has been with us since the outset of this particular activity, Mr. Mark Miller. Mark, you've attended quite a number of these marathons. How would you rate this one?
Excellent. This was a very good marathon.
Did you have a good time?
Yes.
Okay. Generally speaking, everybody has been pleased with this. What made this one, do you think, a notch above? We doubled what we earned, so that its purpose first to raise money, its second purpose to give the kids an opportunity to have a good time, and of course then we did everything else under the sun. But what, from your perspective, made it such a success?
Good music and good fellowship. Just, everybody's really nice. Everybody had a really good time with each other.
Good. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, at this particular time, we're going to simply move the operation downstairs to the Odeon, and we're going to finish the activity with the boys and girls who have made the evening such a success. Let me say, since the chaos there will probably not allow us to do so, that I appreciate your watching, and again I'd like to express my thanks to the Comcast Cablevision Corporation, the Upper Moreland School District, the New Jersey Public Broadcast System, to all of the parents, to the staff especially, to the kids, the board of CineKid, and I would also belatedly but with heartfelt thanks like to extend my gratitude to WCSD Radio for once again sticking with us and providing our FM audience with an opportunity to share this year's program. And now we go directly to the Roger L. Gordon Odeon and the conclusion of the 1984 CineKid Dance Marathon. We're on the countdown now. We're going to be wrapping up. I want you to listen very, very carefully. You have, on paper at least, managed to do the most basic thing of all, and that's more than double what we were able to earn last year. We are over twice the amount of capital that we raised. We want to finish up on an especially high note. I would like to ask you to remember to do the following things, and I'd like you to listen very, very carefully, because I don't want anybody leaving here tonight without fulfilling the following responsibilities. A marathon success rests in two things. You've accomplished the first, and that's staying a part of an event right to the end. When you leave, you have to take with you the necessary sponsor sheets so that you can collect the capital, and we're going to do this within a very short period. We're going to have all the money in before the 12th of May, and all of those prizes are going to be awarded on Saturday night, May the 12th. All of the money has to be back, and we have to watch it very carefully, because this is where the prize difference generally falls. Because people usually give you a little more than they pledged. Not always, but that dollar or two may mean the difference between somebody getting one prize or another. That's the first thing. When you leave tonight, make sure you have that. The second thing is that any of our ladies and gentlemen who are willing to stick around for about 15 or 20 minutes to help us just simply move the basic gear out, I'd like you to do so, because none of us plan to return on Sunday, and we have to have this gear relocated very quickly. And of course, the third thing is that we'd like you to make sure that you are able to toast the occasion before it actually arrives. So what I'd like you to do now is to move to the back and make sure that you get your champagne and have it ready, and we're going to bring up some music for about 2 or 3 minutes, and then we're going to toast it and do an official countdown, because at midnight you will have broken every record from every previous dance marathon that has ever been held here. Okay? That's it.
The winner of that contest was Chris Bressler.
Hey, it's 1984. It's a good year.
Wow. Thank
Don't
you.
Drink it.
That's crazy.
Now put on the hood and give me a drink.
Okay, let's everybody up and like the staff members up here, and let's all get up here and keep an eye together on the clock.
Oh my God.
90 seconds to go. Make sure that you have a
little,
it's perfectly safe. One minute and 15 seconds. Where are the teachers? Michael? Mr. Abbott?
She's
over there. 50 seconds.
Pretty news. 40 seconds.
After the marathon, I'm at my house. We're having a dance party.
30 seconds.
I'll be there, Scott.
Don't forget, it's no good unless. Don't forget, it's no good unless they you leave with the sheets. Okay, 15 seconds.
Put on your head, Scott. Put on your head.
10.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
That's it!
How come we play the Phillies game at Ford? Everybody
go to sleep!
I think I'm drunk.
Alright. Okay, on behalf of everybody, you've done it. 16 hours straight. We won't know for a couple of days exactly how much, but you are past the 2x mark. You earned twice as much this year. You broke every record that ever existed before. That much you are sure of. Big hand for yourself. And to everybody who's watching, good night and God bless.
Yeah.